There are times when we do not need some parts of certain objects of the shapes we have drawn. When these objects intersect, we can cut the parts we do not need using the point of intersection as a cutting boundary. To do this, we simply have to use the trim command. To get a better picture of how the trim tool can be used, a drawing has been created to help me give you some examples. The trim tool can be found in either the Modify menu or in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. The quickest way to use this tool efficiently is to activate it and press Enter before I proceed to trim anything. In this way, every object of the shape is a cutting boundary. So without further ado, I will zoom in on the first example to trim the parts I do not need to create the final shape. As you can see, every time I click on a part, the part is being removed. I can click the parts one by one or use the crossing selection to remove more parts simultaneously. When I'm done trimming, all I need to do is press Enter or Escape to exit the command. However, there are times when it's easier to define a center boundary instead of clicking again and again. To prove my point, I will move on to the next example. Let's say I want to trim the horizontal lines up to the second spline they meet. I will activate the trim tool again and press Enter like I did before. In this way, I have to click at least two times to achieve the desired result. I will exit the command and click on the Undo button from the Quick Access toolbar. Now I will activate the trim tool again, press Enter, and look at the command line. AutoCAD provides us with some different methods for trimming. In this case, I will click on Cutting Edges to set the boundary. Then, I will select the second spline and press Enter. At this point, I am going to select all the lines I wish to trim. Notice that no matter what I select, the lines will be trimmed up to the second spline, which is the cutting boundary. In this way, the trimming process was quite easier and surely quicker. In the last example, I will show you another useful method for trimming objects. Imagine that I want to trim the left vertical line where it was supposed to intersect with the horizontal line if the horizontal line had greater length. For this reason, I will activate the trim tool again and press Enter. However, when my cursor moves to the line, the application does not let me trim this line. A message appears instead that informs me that the line does not intersect with the cutting edge. In this case, to trim the line, I have to either create a horizontal line that actually intersects with a vertical one, or I can select the edge option in the command line. In this example, I will select the edge option and then I will activate the extend mode. Now, I will proceed to trim the left vertical line again. Notice that I can trim either the upper or the lower part of this line as if the horizontal line actually intersected with it. I will trim the upper side by clicking on it and then I will deactivate the command. When you finish with the edge option, it is highly recommended that you activate the tool and return the edge mode to no extend. The reason I recommend this is because the extend mode can create confusion when we trim in general, because every object in the drawing that apparently intersects with the object we want to trim will be a cutting boundary. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that although there are more trim options in the command line, the options that were shown are what you will most likely need.